Jai Gurudev children, how are you all? Are you all writing your classwork notes? Good. Let's start today's class with a rhyme.
One lonely kangaroo waiting for a friend, one more joined it, and then there were two. Two little kangaroos playing a game, one more joined them, and then there were three. Three frisky kangaroos wishing there were more. There comes one, and then there were four. Children, frisky means which is very happy and full of energy, like you all. Four lovely kangaroos jumping up high. One more joined them, and then there were five. Five little kangaroos hopping in the sun. Together they played and had a lot of fun.
Children, in the rhyme we saw, first there were only two kangaroos, correct? Now, later we saw one more kangaroo joined it, isn't it? So now tell me, 2 plus 1 is how much? You're correct. 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. What did we do just now? We added. You all remember this, right? We have learnt how to do single digit addition, isn't it? Children, do you observe the fruit inside the baskets there? Yes, there are two baskets. Now, in basket A, can you tell me how many fruits are there? You're correct, there are three apples. Now, in basket B, can you tell me how many fruits are there? Yes, there are four apples. Now, let's put these two together and find out how many total number of apples are there. Okay, now first let's write in basket A, how many apples are there? Yes, there are three. Now, in basket B, we have four apples. So how much is 3 plus 4 children? It is 7. Very good. Now let's try to first count the apples in basket B, and to it let's add apples in basket A. Okay, so in basket B we know there are 4 apples, and in basket A there are 3 apples. Now tell me, how much is 4 plus 3? It is 7, isn't it? When we observe here, we see that 3 plus 4 is also 7, 4 plus 3 is also 7. This is called as turn around facts. Understood, children? Children, here we have to add numbers 4 and 5. So we'll keep the bigger number in our mind. Now tell me, which is the bigger number here, 4 or 5? Yes, 5. So let's keep number 5 in our mind and add number 4 to it. So open 4 fingers. Now we have to count forward or backwards? Yes, we have to always count forwards when we have to do addition. So 5 in your mind, 4 on your fingers. Let's count. After 5, it is 6. 7, 8 and 9. So how much is 5 plus 4 children? It is 9. Very good. We'll try for one more number. We have to add 8 plus 3. Now tell me here, which is the bigger number? Yes, it is 8. So let's keep 8 in our mind and take out 3 fingers. Let's add now 8 plus 3. After 8, it is 9, 10 and 11. So 8 plus 3 is 11. Did you understand, children, how to add two numbers? Good. Children, can you see the numbers given here? Now let's start to add. We'll go to the first box. Here you see numbers given on the top and to the left side, isn't it? Now I'll let you know how to add the numbers given here. Okay, first, after the plus symbol on the top, can you tell me which number is there? It is 5. So first we'll take number 5 and let's add it with number 4. So tell me, how much is 5 plus 4? It is 9. You're correct. Now let's take number 3 and let's add it with 4. Okay, so tell me, how much is 3 plus 4? It is 7. Then let's take number 2 and add that with 4. So 2 plus 4 is 6. You're correct. Now we are done with the first line. Now we'll go to the next line. Even here we have to always start with the first number on the top. That is number 5. So 5 plus 1 is 6. Then 3 plus 1 is 4. 2 plus 1 is 3. 5 plus 0 is 5. 3 plus 0 is 3. 2 plus 0 is 2. Did you understand, children? Now let's try one more. We'll go to the next box. Here on the top we see numbers 4, number 8 and number 1. And to the left side we see number 5, number 2 and number 6. So we'll take number 5 first and add that with all the numbers on the top. Okay, so tell me, how much is 5 plus 4? It is 9. How much is 5 plus 8? Keep the bigger number in your mind, smaller number on your fingers, and tell me the answer, children. 5 plus 8 is 13. Very good. 5 plus 1 is 6. Yes. Now we are done with the first line. We'll go to the next number now. Here the next number is 2. We have to add 2 with all the numbers given on the top. So 2 plus 4 will be 6. 2 plus 8 is 10. 2 plus 1 is 3. Now we'll go to the next number here. We are done with adding all the numbers with 2. We'll start with number 6. 6 plus 4 is 10. 6 plus 8 is 14. And 6 plus 1 is 7. Did you understand, children? This is called as addition table. Did you understand? Children, turn to page number 45 in Bal Ganit. Write today's date. Here we see few pictures. We have to find out the total number of objects in each picture. First one is done. We'll go to the second one. Now tell me, how many butterflies you can see? There are 5. Correct. 5 plus, next how many butterflies do we see? 3. Correct. Now tell me, total how many butterflies are there? Let's add 5 plus 3 and find out how many are there. Correct. There are 8 butterflies. We'll go to the next one. Count and tell me, how many trees do you see? There are 4. To that, let's add 3 more trees. Now find out and tell me, children, total how many trees are there? Yes, there are 7 trees. Let's go to the next one. Count the number of apples and tell me. There are 6, correct. Then to that, let's add 4 more apples. Now tell me, total how many apples are there? There are 10. Next, there are 6 kites. To that we shall add 2 kites. Now tell me, total how many kites are there? You're correct, there are 8 kites. Now let's turn to page number 46. Here you have to add the following numbers and write the sum. We'll have to count by keeping the bigger number in our mind, smaller number on our fingers and do the addition here. Okay, so tell me, how much is 3 plus 6? Here 6 is the bigger number. Let's keep 6 in our mind, 3 on our fingers, and count backwards or forwards. Yes, when we do addition, we always have to count forwards. So after 6, 7, 8, 9. So let's write the answer, 9. Now 8 plus 1. It is 9. So how much is 9 plus 1? It is 10. Let's add 7 and 5. Keep 7 in your mind, 5 on your fingers, and count, children, after 7. It is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So let's write 12. Next, 4 plus 6, it is 10. 3 plus 7, 10. 8 plus 9, 17. 7 plus 0, it is 7. 8 plus 5, it is 13. 4 plus 3 is 7. 2 plus 9 is 11. Very good. Now next sums, I want you to pause the video, solve it on your own, and then check the answers. Okay? 8 plus 8 is 16. 0 plus 5 is 5. 1 plus 9 is 10, 2 plus 6 is 8, 5 plus 5 is 10, 8 plus 3 is 11, 4 plus 9 is 13, 2 plus 7 is 9. Children, I hope you all have got your answers correct. We learned about turnaround facts, right? We have to do the same here on page number 47. We have to write the turnaround facts for the given numbers. So for question A, you have to write for numbers 3 and 8. So what will be the numbers, children? It will be 8 and 3. Very good. Now tell me, for 4 and 5, it will be 5 and 4. Very good. For 2 and 4, it will be 4 and 2. For 1 and 7, it will be 7 and 1. For 8 and 1, it will be 1 and 8. Very good. So now let's answer the next two questions. If I know that 6 plus 2 is equal to 8, then I also know that dash plus dash is equal to 8. So what are the numbers we have to write there? Yes, it will be 2, then it will be 6. Correct. We'll go to the second one. If I know that 2 plus 4 is equal to 6, then I also know that 4 plus dash is equal to 6. So which number will come there? Going to be 2. Very good. Children, on page number 48 in your Bal Ganit, you have addition table, and there's a small activity there. I want you to try it on your own. We will check for the answers in our next class. Okay? I hope you all have completed your homework on page number 24, where you had to arrange the numbers from small number to big number. Check for the answers, children. Children, this was on page number 25, where you had to arrange numbers in decreasing order, that is from big number to small number. Check for the answers, children. Let's all meet in our next class. Take care of yourself. Jai Gurudev.